Hi, this is start video about Fox, currency switcher professional for WooCommerce. After installation of the plugin, let's activate it. After activation, let's go to its settings. Also, you can go to its settings through the section WooCommerce Settings Currency. Firstly, we can add another currency. Let's write here currency coded. If you do not know what currency codes you want to apply, you can go here and find currency codes for each country, copy and paste. Okay, just for added currency, we can select its symbol, how to place its symbol related to the price, currency rate. We can set it manually, or using this button, you can set it automatically. If it doesn't work for you and you will find here any message, you can go to the options and select another currency aggregator. After selection, you can shoot go and click save changes. Let's back to the Yahoo Finance. Next, you can add to the currency rate your interest. You can write here in two ways, using float or in the classic way. Next, how to show separator. Just look how it looks and select the way you like. Visible. If any currency is added to the system, it can be not visible on the front side. It's depending on your business. You can use this currency, but not show to your customers. Show sense or hide sense. Description. Any text for this currency. For example, after this, click on Save Changes. Next, what is useful? It set flags for each currency. Just click on this icon and select flags you have. Save changes. After all settings done, on the side front, you will not see currency switcher. You should set it. So here's three ways you can set the currency switcher on the side front. First one and the quickest is go to the site and enable this switcher. Let's just click save changes. Update the front. And you will find here currency switcher. That's all. Okay, just now let's set currency switcher into another way. Let's set it into sidebar. Let's go to the widgets, appearance, widgets. Let's select, click on plus. Here, write Fox currency switcher and click on it. Click update. Let's go to the side front and you will see it here. Let's change currency just now. For example, click on JBB. So you can see that currency is changed. Let's back to the USD. Okay, let's click on the euro. And you will find it's also changed. By the way, if you have a lot of currencies and you want to change their rates by one click, just click on this button, update all rates. And you will see it's updated. Don't forget to click Save Changes. Also, if you want to add more than one currency into your system, you can click on Currency Wizard and start to select currencies you want to add. Click on Install selected currencies. After the page reloaded, you will see your selected currencies with the rate already set. Another way, it's using short code. Let's go to the site documentation. Currency switcher, codex, and you will find this short code, books, with a lot of attributes. So I already prepared it. It's for the site header and What I need? I need to insert next instruction, do shortcoding, VOOCs. And by the way, if you do not want to use any skins, you can set CSS class, VOOCs, clean, select. Let's click save. Site front. And you will see currency switcher on the site front in the header. By the way, make your attention of the filter by the price. Native filter by the price of WooCommerce work fine with currency switcher. For example, let's make filtering by this currency. Okay. Let's change the currency, for example, to GBP. And you will see that maximum price by which you can make filtering is recalculated to JBB. Filter. Okay, also make your attention. If you need to add custom currency symbols, additional, for example, you want to change any symbol here, you can go to the add, you can click add custom currency symbols. And add your symbols here. By the way, currency wizard already added it, but you also can click on the comma, add any currency symbol you want. Do not forget to save changes. And let's select this currency symbol for this currency. Let's click. And on the same bottom of the drop-down, you will see this. Let's save changes. Update. Let's select this currency and you will see this custom currency symbol is here. By the way, doesn't matter is currency code exists or doesn't in the reality. For example, you can add your own currency, append currency, code. Doesn't matter what code you write here, for example, XXX. Select here any currency symbol you just added here and write your own currency rate, for example 100. Flag, you can also select any flag, no matter the flag. Let's select any image. Save changes. Let's go to the site front and let's update it. And you will find it here. And we will see that prices are shown in the currency which doesn't really exact in the reality. Also, another way how to set the currency. Here's tab designer. Go to its tab and click create. Go to edit. And here you can create your customized currency switcher dropdown. Just use these options. And don't forget to save change, save and exit, for example. Next, then click copy this shortcode, go to the appearance widgets, add here text, click paragraph, paste code here, shortcode, OK, update. Let's go to the site front, update, and you will see currency switcher here. Okay, last, let's add any product to the cart, add to cart, and we'll see, by the way, if our currency is JBP, all the products which in the cart will be calculated in JBP. Okay, let's click view cart, the same here in JBP, and let's go to checkout. But look at this. Currency is reset to the USD. Why is it? If you want, let your customers pay in the selected currency in the tab advanced and select here is multiply allowed to yes. Save changes. And now let's go back, reselect JBP, checkout. We see on the checkout JBP. Okay, place order. Okay, order is done. So, it's calculated in JBP. We can go to our WooCommerce orders, and we'll see this order, which is calculated in JBP, if you can enter on it. By the way, when you enter it into the order, if you want to buy any case change its currency, you can click on this button and select any other currency. For example, let's select euros, recalculate order. Okay. And it will be recalculated related to the current currency rate, which is existing just now. But also, we can another way recalculate it. As you can see, you're free how you want to manage your currencies in your shop, even if it's related to the currency orders. Also, another option, welcome currency. For example, if you have basic currency as USD, but you won't let your customers see firstly on their first visit another currency, you can select it on welcome currency, and user with his first visit on your shop will see selected currency here, welcome currency. It's enough for the first video. See you on the next videos. Bye.